got thrown down. More stairs. In another location. But this time it wasn't some angry sodomite that was upset with me. It did it out of spite, as they do, as they're prone to do. God, you're gonna be working for his opponent, whether you do so intentionally. And I think a lot of people are doing that, and of course they're not cognizant of anything that they really believe. These people are known as useful idiots to the elite. And useful idiots will say and do whatever they're told to without a second thought. And we know their eventuality. And some of them, they work for the devil knowingly. While others, they don't realize that it's actually the communist machine. And if you try to tell them, they'll accuse you of something that's totally opposite of what you're doing. And I know that my humor and my presentation resonates. Yeah, I know that my opinions stink up the room, but that doesn't matter. As long as I'm funny, I can get away with anything. And I realize this, and that's a gift. That what I do is second to the fact that I realize the things that I realize. I wouldn't be able to do this with impunity. I wasn't wildly free from all the ties that bind me, bind the rest of society. I don't seem to be the slightest bit concerned with what they're talking about in the news cycle. They just recycle and recycle and recycle, because chaos and destruction never get old. Fear-mongering, and buy this thing, buy that thing. No, that'll never get old, 'cause that shit'll always get sold. And as long as there's something to sell, there's a lie that they will continue to tell. And you can tell that I haven't done this in a little while, 'cause I feel like I'm on my A-plus game. 'Cause I did something that brings me much shame. Man, I have to admit it to you now. I live in my own little world. I've always lived in my own little world. But sometimes that has devastating consequences. Because when I'm up all night touching myself, and it doesn't matter all the goals that I want to accomplish. It doesn't matter that I claim to be a woman of God when I get so obsessive compulsive that I can't stop myself. 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 From my excessive isolation, I realize that there's nobody that can do anything for me that I can do for myself. And they say that sin is separation from God, but I never feel separated when I do these things that I'm told are really terrible. Because I know that God's there, God's always there, He'll always be there, and He's watching me, and maybe He's shaking His head, or maybe He's going, really, Amy? Again? Yeah, so Lord, again and 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 again. Body knows the world I'm living in. He sees the world that I'm living in. He's the only one there. He's the only one there. It's me and me. Secondary versions of reality. I live in a parallel universe. It's far better than your universe. And I would rather be here than anywhere else in the motherfucking world. I'm sitting here waiting to discount tire. My warranty has not expired, which is a good thing, since this is probably the fifth time that I've had to do this shit. And that's not just because of my piss poor driving, that's because the roads are shit. I have no problem admitting that I'm a terrible driver. I have a vagina, after all. And my license should probably be revoked. But since we live in a country that's all about equality and shit, you can pretty much guarantee that a crazy bitch is gonna keep on tearing up the road and tearing up her car, and that's what happens. When you say that women can be men, they can do stuff that men do, then they'll attempt to, and fail 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 and fail. But really though, I had a nail in my car, in my, I'm pretty sure, I remember when it happened too. I was like, yeah, I'm probably gonna have to go back to Discount Tire. Yeah, my tire is like totally flat. It's kind of ridiculous that I even made it here.